Hello and welcome to Positive Life Principles. I'm Carol Ladd. I'm thrilled you joined me today. Today is President's Day. And as we think about the lives of Washington and Lincoln, we learn many great truths from both of their lives. Especially, I'm thinking about a story with George Washington. It's called Bulletproof Washington. And this particular story occurred in 1755 during the French and Indian War. General Washington was serving alongside General Braddock in his British troops. And as they were fighting a battle, and it was a defeating battle, it was a discouraging battle, and Washington was riding amongst the troops, trying to encourage them and build up their resolve. And as he did, other officers who were riding along him all were shot and killed, and even General Braddock lost his life. It was a terrible battle. But Washington rode and made it through that battle unscathed. And it was interesting because he was shot at over and over again. Here's what Washington wrote to his brother days after the battle. He said, "But by the all-powerful dispensations of Providence, I have been protected beyond all human probability or expectation, for I had four bullets through my coat and two horses shot under me, yet escaped unhurt, although death was leveling my companions on every side of me." Washington recognized the hand of God in protecting him during this battle. But not only did Washington recognize it, but 15 years later, an old Indian chief came to Washington and said, "I want to meet you, the bulletproof warrior." And he recognized God's hand in protecting George Washington. Here's what the Indian chief had to say about Washington. "Listen, the great Spirit protects that man," pointing at Washington, "and guides his destinies. He will become the chief of nations, and a people yet unborn will hail him as founder of a mighty empire. I am come to pay homage to the man who is the particular favorite of heaven and who can never die in battle." Another great warrior wrote this: "Washington was never born to be killed by a bullet. I had 17 fair fires at him with my rifle, and after all, could not bring him to the ground." Yes, God had a great purpose for Washington. Not only did Washington realize it, but the Indians that they fought against recognized it. You know, God not only had a great purpose for Washington, but God has a great purpose for your life too. And we need to recognize that God does have a purpose and a plan for each one of our lives. It may not include being president of the United States or faring through battle, leading a nation on to victory, but it may be in a small way, in a simple way. It may be having victory in your home as you set a Christ-like example. It may be having victory in your work as you set as you are a light shining in the darkness. Look for God's purpose in your life. Ask Him to continue to guide you, but recognize that He is doing a great work. Even through the battles in your life, He is doing a great work. Wait on Him, look to Him, and find your strength and direction in the Lord. Just as Washington gives us a great example, let us look to the Lord to lead us and guide us in all that He has planned and purposed for each one of us to do for His glory. I hope that this has been an encouraging message for you this week, and I look forward to seeing you next week here at Positive Life Principles.